As I mentioned before, we're going to come in and we're going to cut along the blue line all in one continuous cut, and then we're just going to stop here. Now, before we cut the drawer out of Totoro, I strongly, strongly recommend that you ask your teacher for a practice piece, much like this one. You want to feel like you have mastered this one continuous cut before you go and do it on the real thing. Because if you screw up or it looks badly, there's no fixing it. So I'd advise you, ask your teacher for as many of these as you need. Keep practicing until you feel comfortable with this. All right, so I'm just gonna show you some do's and don'ts when you're making a cut much like this. So I'm going to lower the blade guard. I'm also going to want to have a push stick handy, so I'm just gonna keep that to the side in case I need it. And we're gonna make this cut. So we're gonna start, we're gonna come in through here. And we're gonna try to stay in the middle of the red line. All right, as you're cutting, you should focus on the next curve. So I should be looking over here. So I'm gonna begin my curve. And now I'm looking over here. If for some reason you were to go off the line, you want to continue cutting. You want to just slowly turn back. And you want to slowly come back to that red line. And now we're back. This is what you should do. Now let's pretend we come off the line again. What you do not want to do is pull back and recut. Do not pull back and recut like this. As you're finishing your cut, you may want to hold onto the center piece and make that cut. When you're done, stop the machine and step on the brakes. And you want to leave it like this. Then you want to lock out your machine, make sure it doesn't turn on. And we're going to go ahead and lift the blade guard. We can lift up our project like this. We can grab our drawer. And then as we're pulling out here, we're going to use our push stick and we're just gonna apply some pressure down like this. And get that out like that. Now, as I was doing this practice piece, you can see that I made two mistakes. I started to go off the line over here. And so what I did was I began to try to correct it. And you know, it looks okay. I mean, I'm not particularly thrilled with this bump here. So what I would have done is if I were off the line, I would have just slowly tried to gradually make a new circle line and rejoin the red line when I'm over here. That's probably what I would have done. But you know what? Besides that little bump, the gap looks normal. It looks pretty decent. If we look on this side over here, this is where I pulled back and I hesitated. And I just pulled back until I could get back onto the line. And as you can sort of see, there's this big, ugly black gap over here. And sadly, I'm stuck with that for the rest of my project. So as I mentioned before, before you commit to the real thing, you want to do as many practice pieces as you can so you feel comfortable with this cut.